I have not given you the spirit of fear. I have given you the spirit of boldness, the spirit of a sound mind. I prophesy with my two eyes closed, that power shall be destroyed. You will not see it again. In the name of Jesus.
Lamentations chapter 1 Verse 22. Is that book in the Old Testament? The Bible said, saw in the night, and her tears are on her cheeks. Among all her lovers, she had no one to comfort her. All her friends have dealt treacherously with her. They have become her enemies. Let us pray. Father, convert this word in a language that is simple for us to understand. And let the meditations of our heart and the words of our mouth after now be acceptable in your sight. Amen. And let it be testimony to show. Break us and mold us anew. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I will speak with you on a topic that I've titled, Sorrow Might Endure for the Night, but Joy Cometh in the Morning. Tell your neighbor, Joy Cometh in the Morning.
Joy Cometh in the Morning.
The Bible says she weepeth at night. She cries. She's in sorrow. She's in pains. Anguish. From this context and put you in that position. Every one of you here has something you cry about. Let us be plain about life. Many of us did not come because we want to worship God today. Many of us are not here this morning because we want to give Him praise. Many of us left our home to be here. We want to see Jesus and glorify Him. We're not here to thank Him for the past week. We're here because something bothers us. We're here because we need a transformation. We're here because we need change in our life. We're here because we want to go to the next level. We're here because we want to prove to the enemy that of a truth, God is with us. We're here because we want our bank account and our life to change. We're here because we need a touch of God for healing. We're here because there is no food in our house. We're here because our business is no longer working the way it is. These are the things that make you sorrowful. Even when you sit among friends, even when you sit among colleagues, your smiles are smiles of pretense. Your smiles are smiles of pretense. Your smiles are just makeup over your face. Your smiles are the foundation that a woman places on her face to hide her pimples and rashes. Your smiles are just like the foundation that covers the wrinkles of old age. Your smiles are just like that beautiful cloth you wear to cover the sickness in you. That beautiful cloth that covers the scars in your body. Your smiles are not real. Why? Because there is a pain in the heart. Why? Because there is something that bothers you. Why? Because you cannot sleep at night because of an oppression of the wicked. Why? Because you cannot dwell in peace and enjoy life to the fullness because there are wicked people that surround you and want to oppress you and drink you down. Says she cries at night. Now, I want to let you know that this person that was crying at night was not alone. The Bible made reference that she had what? A lover. The Bible also made reference that this one had friends. But where are they when you were crying? Where are your friends when you feel pain? These friends, most of them only come to laugh with you when you laugh. But they're not there to feel the pains in your heart. Because it's only the one who wears the shoe that knows where it pinches him. Am I complicated?
Yes.
And the Bible said she cried, she had anguish, she had pain, she was sorrowful, and there was nobody to comfort her. Many of you, you have come to the crossroads. You have come to the very point, the very place, when you look behind, there is no man. Child of God, I want you to be strong again. I come to encourage you to pick up your mantle again. Listen to me. It is when you pick up the mantle that the battle in your life are terminated. Without the mantle, the battle will be fierce. My strength shall no man prevail. This is why your friends can fail you. Said what? The lover. I can imagine some of you. I've been in love before. Can I see you? I've been in love before. Oh, I'm still in love right now. Let me see you. Just wait for me to Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, some
love.
Of you have been in love, some of you have fallen out of love, some of you have fallen in love, and some of you are still kind of in love. Sleeping. And you know, when you're in love, or rather, what people call love today, promises have been made. I'll stand by you. I will be there by you. At all times, I'll stand by you. When you cry, I have my shoulder. You can lean on me. I will never disappoint you. I am your best friend. See me as everything. Cast all your cares on me. Give me your problem, I will bear them with you. Now, these are the promises of love, right? And some men will tell you, I will do anything to satisfy you. Some days will tell you, I will be there solidly behind you. I will stand firm behind you. Nothing can stop my love. Just a little praise. Just a little praise. Look around and you will not see your love again. All the promises of man disappears in the twinkling of an eye. That is what men do. Generally, your uncle can promise you heaven and earth. Your father can give you all the assurance. But finally, what will happen? They will fail you. The Bible said there, I want to go back. Let's go back again to that very place. Amen. During the daytime, there is a cover of smell. How you doing now? Oh, thank God. Glory to Jesus. Ross, how are you today, man? I'm alive. Glory to God. You're looking bright. Oh, yes. Why won't you look bright? Oh, you have some foundation on your face. Mary Kay. I call it Mary Kay smile. Take away the Mary Kay, I will see the wrinkles. Take away the Mary Kay, I will see the rashes. Yes, without the foundation, there are lots of wrinkles. No, don't look at our movie stars the way they are on television. Our face with a lot of things. Cover up our problems in the presence of people. Now, you will never know the problem of a man when he says, and here, the Bible says she went and she wept at night. Now, why is she weeping at night? It is because at this time, she noticed that she is what? Lonely. What did you do when you were alone? Take away the pretense. We're in the presence of God. In the presence of God, there is liberty. Freedom. It's like democracy. And then, what shows here? Because she's alone, her pain now surrounds her. She cries. There are tears on her cheeks. And I can see the tears wiping away the foundation. And the real problem that you've been trying to hide is now staring at you. What is your problem? The problem of delayed marriage? The problem of instability in your finances, your problem of joblessness, your problem of childlessness, your problem of sickness, your problem too numerous to mention. They are staring directly at you. And remember, there are some of these problems I've shared with friends. You have shared with the ones who promised you love. You have shared with the one that said it's going to be your backbone. But now, they cannot help you. The Bible said, among all our lovers, what a clause. Is that your Bible? He said, among all our lovers. We're not talking about one person. Okay, I don't want to pass my eggs in one basket. Yes, please don't do this. Because I know, talking from experience, a lot of good ladies, you actually act like this. I don't want to pass my eggs in one basket. I want to separate them. So I'll share my love into that. Healthy men, Instagram, and your son. Among them, I will go the new one. And I will marry that one. Shout out. The only prostitute. No, how can a lady come to the church and say, pastor, pray for me? And when the pastor will pray, say, I've got names and just come. Okay, bring the names, let me see. It's not even two. Let's say, okay, let's do two, God to go past the baby. What you are bringing is seven. 8, 15 names. Only you. Now, the Bible said, amongst all her lovers, there was none. No man just know one man. No. Every man has an associate of people. Amongst all our friends, amongst all our lovers, they are not other. Now these are the people, when I talk about lovers, I'm talking about lovers both of male and female. Not necessarily in the worldly part, I'm talking about those who can comfort you. Amen. Hello? Yeah. I'm going to be digressing. But if it's time to talk about some other things, I'll digress a little and then talk about it and come back. Now, amongst those who can comfort you, those who can pamper you, those who can now give you the push, because you know, there are some ideas that can come into your life. If you can, if you don't have people who pamper and push you into it, you can't go forward. Now, this is what I love. Amen? Do I have people in the house?
Yes, sir.
So if I am. Now Jesus is the only one who can assure you of a bright future without tears. The lovers could not comfort her. Amen.
Amen.
Then look at the word of our friends. Many of you say friends are even closer than brothers. Are you aware? Friends. A friend can die for you, but I don't know about your brother. Yeah.
They are closer than family. Yes, God is thicker than water. Yes, I agree. But the word friend is a different word.
Don't be the type of the talk. I friend this man, I friend that woman. Shut up. That is rubbish. Are you hearing me? I'm talking about friendship. A ship that lasts forever and does not sink. Our friends, preciously, becoming enemies. Well, your friend becomes your enemy, is finished. Oh, yes. When family tries to destroy you, you run to friends as confidants. Amen. Will keep you. Now, the friend that you think will keep you now, preciously, freakishly, with machine in their heart, has turned around to be those that will pull you down. Now, can I tell you something? Your brother does not know your secret. Hello? Your mother does not know your secret. Your father does not know your secret. Who knows your secret? Your secret. Your friends. Can you see how close friends are? That is why I advise young people today. I said, when you want to get married, don't marry because of love. Any of you are looking at me? Why would I marry? Why would I marry because of love? No. Don't marry because of money. Marry for friendship. Amen.
Amen.
If you marry your friend, you enjoy your marriage. My father is my friend. So, I can talk to my father easily. When my father is my boss, I'll be restricted, right?
Yes.
My wife is my friend. That is why I can share confidential things with her. Now, do you know that there are some marriages here? You can't talk to your wife, or you can't talk to your husband. You did not marry for friendship, you married for something else. Let me just digress and leave you. I'll come back to what I'm talking about. Amen. This is the wisdom center. You get different kinds of wisdom from different places. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Marriage should not be centered on love, but should be centered on friendship. My father said something about 1 month ago during the women's convention in the church. She said, he said, women are not supposed to love their husband. You need to see us. But this man don't want to say. But he said, the love is supposed to come from the man. How could they love you and the man will love you? You need to see us. Even those of us that the pastor says, ah, Papa, I've been talking to you before, but this one, he can't speak. And you see someone that says, yes. By the end of the day, we saw that there is something more than love. That the woman has to give the husband respect. Well, if you don't know this, you go respect her. Yes, and the woman owes the husband respect. And respect is reciprocal by law. That's what the Bible said. Women, respect your husband. Like some of you now, you will come and say, I'm sitting there on that place. You women, you will come, you will lay down for me. Meanwhile, I don't live for your husband. If I be your husband, after this service, I will deal with you. Hello? I want to cause some problems today. Are you hearing me? I am causing problems in your marriage now so that you can amend well. Amen? And so, at the end of the day, some of you here, you see your pastor better than your husband. No. Your husband is your head. After that message, when I went home, my wife was putting food on the table. She was standing and said, Oli, name that. You said what? I said, yes, that is the way you give it on the wedding day. Continue doing it for now. You can't show them outside that you are doing that dead inside. Hallelujah. Let's go back to what I was talking about. Amen.
So when your friends turn their back on you, you are totally finished. They say you have become enemies.
Now, child of God, the people that you are pursuing the same place, you think you are pursuing the same cause, they turn out to join your enemies to fight against you, you are finished. Many of you know what this, you know what I'm talking about. You are facing a political career, you want to get it. And then you have friends who are supporting you. Now when you have your friends supporting you, you feel strong. Automatically you hear that one of them, they count. How do you feel?
Fear comes.
Fear comes.
friends are no longer there. Now, child of God, this is the reason why you must not depend on man, but must depend on God. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our pains and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God. Now, I look at this song. I made a total reflection and I knew that it is not man that I need. It is God that I need. Let's go to the Bible. We have waited a long time. People shall pay. That's 37.
All right. People shall pay. People shall pay. The Bible says,
"For yet a little while, and he that shall come will come."
And we don't want time.
He is the one you need. You might not be seeing him, but he will come. It was the situation that God passed through that made God say something in the Bible, Joseph 10 verse 26. He said, "When I look for good, then it will come to me. And when I waited for light, yet in darkness." 1026. I looked for good, it came. I waited for light and darkness came. Now, I asked, why was this place God? It is because God was not present at the present place. His presence was not felt. Job did not seek him. Seek me now. Seek me now. Brothers, have you been waiting for your friends to help you? Have you been waiting for your husband, your wife, your loved ones to be your help? Yes, men will come for their wife and their husband for change in their life. Hello? Yes, they will fail you. I know about people who travel to Europe, UK, to America, so on and so forth. And when they travel, they feel that the first thing to do is to do what? Get a wife or get a husband in pretense. Not to do what? Forget the papers, right?
Yeah.
So you can see that you can also put hopes on men, on women, your husband, your wife, your friends to help you. But they will fail. There are people who are married like this and then they fail. Some of them even got the paper, you know. They got the paper, they got the connection, and they made it. And automatically, you hear the lady say one day, "Oh, I'm no longer interested in this marriage." And because they know in that country that when the woman gets angry, the man will lose. All you just need to do is take your things and leave the house. Men can fail, women can fail, friends can fail. Cast your cares upon Jesus. After the rain comes the sun. Sorrow and the girl for the night. The Bible said she was crying at night. Many of us are not praying in our house. We pray mostly at night. Hello?
Go pray at night. You now see a prayer boy.
God with him. I don't want that brother to come. That is one of the best prayer boy people pray. At night, when the darkness is everywhere, you see nothing but yourself. Then you know who is with you.
That is when God steps in. When you cast your problems on God, He carries you from that night to the daybreak. And when it is done, your sorrows have disappeared totally. He will do it for you. I said He will do it for you.
Amen.
And friends and family, turn your back at you. Look unto God. Paul said, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. I know you have had your troubled times. I know you had your troubled days. I know you had that moment of sorrow. I know you had that moment of anguish. I know the better days has passed for many of you. You say, oh, before, I get this thing. Before, I get that thing. You don't say, before, my life will be like this. I've spent money here. Oh, cross, you see, Pastor, why I don't know you this kind of time? Pastor, you could say you know me before. Yes, you have had your better days. You've had the times when you hardly remember your name. That's why sometimes it's even good that you have some problems. Yes, I said it's good you have some problems. Because if you don't have this problem, you will not remember. At a time of joy, many of you forget the fact that God is alive. So you have a problem to make sure that God is there. And you have it. Not unto death, but to the glory of His name. A man living in Bonny Island will not know the importance of light until he comes to worry. Oh yes, Bonny Island happens to be the only place in Nigeria where they have 24-hour light constant. So if you live there, you will think that is how Nigeria is. Come and stay for it. You will know the importance. I come to Bonny Island with another. I was surprised that people live in Pasha. You know what they call Pasha? Let me explain for some of you who are born with silver spoon and gold spoon and blue spoon. Pasha is actually a building built with zinc. Sir, they were living in Bacha, but they have AC in Bacha. I have a picture. AC, one inside Bacha, I never see this type. Why? Because light is created into wind. So you will not know the importance of light until you stay in that place. You will not know the importance of friendship until you are close to God. You will not know my importance until the day God will come. Don't look at me like that when he calls me and we answer. Although I'm not ready to go now. I'm just tired. So I want to make the world a better place through you. Through you. Through you. Through you.
Amen.
That is my vision on earth. Now, when you talk around, dry your tears, and look at the person tapping you behind, you will see Jesus. Don't see me. Don't see any pastor. Don't see any prophet. See Jesus. I've said in Revelation chapter 3, verse 10, He said, behold, I stand at the door. Somebody must be inside the house. And this person inside the house does not have Jesus around him. Hello? What surrounds you is darkness, pain, sorrow, anguish, pain, tears. That's the lady we're talking about. That's you. who is having problems right now. That's you that's sick right now. That's you. That who has no money in his bank account. That's you who has lost his job. That's you who wants to get married. That's you who are disappointed. I know. And if you hear my voice, don't let your problem cloud your sense of hearing. Are you hearing me? I was counseling someone. And I told the person, I said, sir, do you know if I'm working with you? He said, for this situation like this, I know she doesn't have a marriage with you. Don't allow your problem rule your sense of reasoning. Don't allow your problems cloud your sense of moving to the next level. When you see great things ahead, look at it and forge ahead. It is what you see that you possess. The Bible said, God told Abraham, don't cry, because I see Abraham crying at the time. He was saying, God, you told me you are giving me all the land, but can I tell you something? God said, yeah, listen. He said, my nephew, I told him to choose, and he took the place where there was plenty, lots of green, everything there was good. But God said, no. Don't allow this problem cloud your sense of seeing. Child of God, what do you see? When I ask this question, some of you say, I just see problem around me. I just see oppression. I just see hunger. No. He said, Abraham, look. And I saw Abraham looking. Now, Abraham not only looked to the left hand side, Abraham looked also to the right hand side. Look forward and he looked backward. And God said, as far as your eye could see. Now, hold on. Before then, Abraham was in anguish and there was a knock at the door. And the Bible said, if any man would hear my voice and open the door, I am coming. And I will what? Sup with him. Now, I am seeing a man who is hungry and have no food. I am seeing a man who does not have anything and is filled with sorrow. And Jesus is saying, I will come and I will sup with you. What do you go eat with you? It is because when Jesus comes to the party, he comes with the items of the party. Jesus is coming into your life with everything that you have lost. Yeah. Like I said, today is your day of rest for remission. Yeah. When God blesses you with rest, you stand at the top and the nation will bow to you.
Amen.
That is my simple definition of restoration. This month of May, may the Lord increase you.
Amen.
This month of May, may the Lord bless you.
Amen.
This month of May, may the Lord shine his countenance upon you. Very close to my bosom,
I spat on his head and I told him, I love you, son, but will never go down. What killed your father will not kill you. My son was seeing me crying and my son began to shed tears. My wife walked into the room and she looked at me. She was not saying anything, but she was trying to get the picture. I looked up at her and I said, don't worry, when I die, my insurance policy will bring a little change. I thought ahead of that. Change my account. The only secret we have is you. For the one I've not changed, you have the pain to eat here. This is the end of the road for me. Tears in my eyes. That night, I looked up to God and I said, God, it's going to be painful, but I can't continue. Men have destroyed their reputation that I have spent so much to build. Men have killed me. With their bitterness and their wickedness, how shall I sing the Lord's song in a strange land? I know what I'm going to do now is a sin, but Father, have mercy on me. Accept my soul when I come, because I cannot sing the Lord's song in a strange land. Many of you have seen this situation. Some of you, yours have not even come close to mine. I looked at my son. I looked at my wife. She was with the baby at the back. The baby at the back does not even know what's happening. That he was about to lose the father that he had. My wife called the other one. Called me to another room that was empty. So you want to kill yourself? Okay. There is no fan here. There is no rope here. There is nothing in this room. Keep yourself in this room. She locked the door. Took the key. I began to search for what will kill me. Now I had those assets to go out. I began to pray God to kill me. If I had nothing that I would kill me, I would kill myself with hunger. Why? Because the wickedness of men that I put my trust on has destroyed everything that I have worked. This is my story. Right. But the more I cried, my problem never disappeared. Instead, my eye is swollen. The more I cried, my problem did not disappear. Death did not come. And I was getting sick. But just at the very moment, when I had access to something that could take my life, I held it up. I would have not been here with you if that day has come to pass. Son, ministerial work is not your work. It is my work. I am the one who sent you. I have seen your desperation. It is part of the training
to the next level. My story and my success story as the General Overseer of Anchor of Restoration International Ministry that has gone far and has been on television also and still was strong and standing up amongst others should tell you that the downfall of a man is not the end. You cannot stand at a position of infidelity, wicked, and thrown to the public. I stood it. That is why today, when you call me, to come and pray for you as a pastor. I will not meet. If you like, let's desire, experience, the best teacher. But the school fees are very expensive. Come and pray, come and pray. And if anything happens, and the next thing on the news, that the cost of speaking with you, married woman. It was not enough. They also said it was maybe the 6 years old child when they caught him. Different kind of news. But look at me. It is me without news that you are listening to. If I killed myself at that time, who will deliver the woman who does not have children yet? Who is going to pray? That to the next level. So, child of God, I want you to see this your crying time as the time for the test of faith to the next level. Hello?
Hi.
I heard the tap on my back. I looked and it was Jesus and he said, I called you. You did not call yourself. People call ministry their work. They say, it is not your work, it is my work. Where I divert you to is where you will go. I thought of that day, it was a Saturday. I went to the church and I preached. The church was jam-packed to the brim and to the overflow. Not people want to listen to me, but people want to see where is that man that is sent. Let us see if we show his face. But I came and I preached Jesus. And healing is a miracle still happening. Today, the same church handed over to my wife is still waxing as strong as it could be, with God still answering, and I am here still doing the work of God in life. Now, you think that your problem is the end of the road, sir. Look very well, it is not the end. The road continues for you. Start your faith. Is your problem depressing you now? Pray away. See Jesus. Have you been crying in silence? Wipe away your tears. That is why you have handkerchief. Handkerchief is for wiping away tears. Please. Throw the handkerchief away. Face God. He will never fail. He has not failed me yet. Jesus Christ will never fail. I have a dream. Song to sing.
You can take the view. Sunday.
Are you just looking at that?
Your place is in Ikoteke.
Yes, that's right. That's very good.
Okay, I got this wrong. I got this wrong. I said incorrect, but you said incorrect. Okay, incorrect.
Thank you.
your son's name? Let me name.
Friday.
Let's say now, Mama.
Yes.
Your son is not an Amora. You?
I know, sir.
You know, sir, you're not an Amora.
Yes, sir.
What do you think you're a mechanic?
Yes, sir.
Eh?
Yes, sir.
I don't know the prayer we pray, but I'll just say, because he's not guilty, God is going to set him free from this. On Friday, this week, at exactly 11:30 in the morning, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
You receive a call that they have released us. It is finished. You don't have to.
Amen.
If God does not tell me, I will not tell you. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Don't worry again. Don't you think? The enemy.
Yes, sir.
Go and tell the Father that sent you. When they release me, please bring me. Tell him to come to their pastor. This is where God lives.
He came to take me to the Yes.
You know, said there are similarities.
Are you hearing me?
In what this one, this PK is talking about is doing for what you are doing. I don't understand. What do you do?
No.
You are a nurse.
Yes.
Where does this PK work?
In the hospital.
In the hospital.
Are
you so your daughter. Okay, stand with her. Are you looking like that?
Put your hands in the name of Jesus.
I want you to know. Okay, come. You did not come out here to look at my face. You came here because you have your own problem.
Yes.
The Lord said you want to settle your problem. Because this is a name I am seeing. Are you hearing me? And this name is you. That you for settlement. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
But the fact the enemy is holding that name. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
What is your name?
Augustina.
Augustina. That is not the name of God is letting me. The Lord is mentioning like Omoye.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Are you just looking at me? This is the name that the enemy packed. Are you hearing me?
Yes,
in the name of the Spirit.
But right now, as I pray, that name will come out of my mouth. Put your destiny.
To my village.
Let's go to my village.
So let's go to my village.
Let's go to my village.
Let's go to my village.
Let's go.
I see a hand from your village. Jesus. Jesus. Are you Emmanuel? Your brother is Emmanuel. You are Emmanuel. Emmanuel. Huh? Your son is Emmanuel. Okay. Your brother is Emmanuel. Hold on, don't rush. No test. Are you Emmanuel? I am a PCI. I am going. This is Africa. I'm still going. This is Accor. I'm still going. When I got to Accor, are you ready? I enter the valley. He's going to open the valley. I enter. Now, I can't open the door, so I stop. The Lord said, cross the road to the other side. I cross the other side. I'm seeing a signboard. The signboard is command secondary school. Look at him. I don't know. You have many things to do. Something like that. Is that your daughter? That's why I am now. I'm going to speak to your father's house. Because you have your father's house, I don't know. There are some plantains. I don't know. There are some plantain trees. Now, inside, that's where they bury your destiny. I am here now. God said, bring back his destiny and restore it back.
Thank you.
people ganging up against me, ganging up against me, because they say, what is this one doing here? What is he doing here? But the Lord said, right now, that yoke will break.
Amen.
Jesus. When you come to him, you don't think that anybody has come to. You will confirm your word spoken through me in their life. God, this is why when you called me, I entered into a negotiation. And I said, Father, you will take one thing and I will take one. And he asked me, son, what do you want from me? I said, give honor to whom honor is due. Give me honor when I speak your word. Why did you take all the glory? And he said, son, go and speak. And when you speak, your words shall be like that of an oracle. Now I speak to my people. Under this very grace and covenant I have with you. That from today, you will honor them above all. Are you hearing me? The Lord said he will fight against them.
Amen.
This is a happy straight attack. Are you hearing me? Amen. And this attack is against your health. But the Lord said today, it is coming to an end also.
Amen.
You is the lip cracker. I use that the word of God to be your father.
I am the Lord. Jesus mighty name.
You that fight your academics, that fight your academics, when you read sometimes understand is the problem. And the Lord said the battle is coming around. Are you hearing me? From now, that letting steady and retentive memory.
Amen. Every guidance. Jesus mighty name.
How is it settled?
Settled.
I know what to do here, but that's a diligence I want to. You know why I keep you here to stand? Because you this place, don't they doubt? They don't doubt here.
I said thank you.
You believe now.
It is now I believe.
It is now you believe. Now I want to go to your house again. I'm in the room with the angels working. Look at what they are bringing out. And you know what? They take me over. I'm in
royal. You know what? They take me over.
Which increase your destiny. I want to uproot it now. Does the father has nothing to do with uphold?
Yes, it was a thief.
I'm coming. Jesus. I uproot the evil. You are supposed to follow the will of the Father. But listen to me. Because you follow Christ, Christ will help you.
Yes.
This is your destiny. Can I give it to you now?
Yes.
Alabama. If you can pronounce this one well, I will give you. Say junction.
Junction.
That is how people will laugh when your glory has been restored.
Jesus mighty name.
I'm anywhere. But don't bank on this one as you are putting all your heart on. Heart on Jesus. He says, he did not see all the lovers, the comforter, and the friends come and become an enemy. I want to speak to you about that. Are you hearing me? I hear the Lord say, your name has been taken away from that place.
Amen.
And your destiny has been restored.
Amen.
Now I see celebration around the corner. Do you know how to dance? You know how to dance? Eh? You know how to dance?
Yes.
You can dance.
Not like that.
Not like that. But if you are in your wedding, can you dance?
Yes.
You can dance anywhere in your wedding.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah, bobo man.
Jesus.
Amen. Are you guys looking like that? received that social payment I told you.
Hey!
When do you want your marriage?
July.
July. Eh? December.
November.
August. December.
December.
Okay. None of you want to marry in September. It's okay, no problem. But September is my birthday, no problem. I pray for you. It's good there is no marriage by that one so that everybody will completely agree. I pray
for you. I believe that on the cover. Jesus' mighty name.
Who the hell is the name of Jesus Christ?
expecting for a long time.
We just put your hands.
That's your amen is not going to go. I saw something that came to pass in my life that I have seen before. Now, as you begin to visualize the future that is great in your life, so will God make it come to pass. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. I call you Jesus, the master of the world.